me about.
Thank you.
I did and other things I can advise you on how to, catfish there. This is my first time fishing the Nanticoke. Basically what I did was I studied the Nanticoke the night before. I used Navionics, the boat app, to find some holes there. And I had a spot I planned to fish, and it worked out perfectly. Basically what I did was anchor up right by Broad Creek and the Nanticoke. They both come together, and there's like a 30-foot hole there. And then there's also a hole on the inside of Broad Creek. We fished that too. It was very successful. We're using chunk bunker, and also we were chumming the water with we took some cans of dog food and poked holes in the top and the bottom and just tied a rope and threw it overboard so that we could retrieve it and throw it away later. So that kind of got them drawn in. The current would pull the dog food out the back end of the can with the water running through the top and out the back, and it drew them in. And I was using slightly heavier gear. I was using my Tsunami rod and also my Tika rod. This is kind of my jetty rod. I also use that for other applications like this too. On this Tika, I have a Penn 4000 with 30-pound test on it. And then on my Tsunami rod, I have the Penn Battle 5000 with 60-pound braid. That's not necessary. It's just I like this rod, and it worked, and it was great for the application. And then my rig was a three-way. So what I did was took some floats off my perch rigs, and I adapted it to my three-way setup. I have my dropper loop. This is for the sinker. I was using 3-ounce sinkers. They were working just fine. You may have to jump up to 4 depending on the current. And then on the end of my other side of the three-way here was my hook. I have an 8-0 circle hook on here with my perch floats attached to it. I snelled this hook and put about a foot and a half to 2 feet of lead line from my three-way with the float and the bead in there. And then the top of I ran a mono between my braid and the three-way. So I have a two-way between the braid and then the mono and then down to the three-way. All of these are uni knots except for the snell. I used the snell uni knot to tie the circle hook. So you're gonna chunk your bunker into three pieces. You'll cut the head off and the tail off, and then cut it into three pieces, and that'll be enough to for your bait. You could go bigger because those catfish in that river get over 20 pounds. The state record was taken out of there a few years back, and at that exact spot, actually, one of them was taken from there. So, 3 to 4 ounce weights, 8-0 hooks, throw your little perch float on there and a bead over top the hook, dropper loop. That's about a foot off the three-way. And then mono between your three-way and your braid. Slightly heavier gear. You could go lighter. I actually switched over to my light gear and it worked just fine. Just keep in mind the weight that you're putting on the hook. If you got to go up to 3 and 4 ounces, you want a heavier rod. So that's your tie-up session for the Nanticoke River Catfish Show. I hope y'all enjoyed it. Get out there and flip some fins.